No, in fact, I think judiciary is a little bit more laxed and has actually refused to actually play to the public gallery. I think they are the only ones now who seem to just want to remain very fixed and not flexible, as other bodies are being more flexible. Because except for the judge who refused to or denied bail to the suspects, I think all the others have been seen to want to exercise, even where they have clear discretion, they have seemed to want to be more fixed to the rules and procedures. Instead of looking at the bigger picture.
Did it strike you as odd that they were denied bail this time around as a lawyer?
No, actually, I think the judge was also very clear, because he actually quoted the Constitution on the magnitude of the problem. Ordinarily, we have every Kenyan actually has a right to get bail, you know. But I saw the judge actually quoting, I think, Article 29 of the Constitution. That, in a way, he kind of used his discretion. And, you know, sometimes that activism with the judiciary is also very important, because it also informs the making of the laws. Once the parliamentarians also listen to some of those things, some of the pronouncements of the judges, that also informs how then we should also be reforming our law. Because we are saying, if someone is really a terrorist, a known terrorist, and we have every reason to believe that they are terrorists, and then the constitution, or rather we still insist that they must still get bail, and they can actually go and still continue doing their terrorist work outside the, as they are going on with the case. Clearly, we are saying there is a problem there. So we need to also be reforming our laws so that they can also now reflect the current realities. Someone who has ripped off this country economically is actually bringing us on our knees. And so a judge showing no mercy to that kind of a person is something that should ring a bell in our minds. But what are we seeing anyway with most of the judges? They are not taking that line of thought. In fact, that I think is a very, very liberal judge. Mm-hmm. Most of the judges would like to cling more on the very strict procedures, yes, that we have in our laws. And hence, you find, like now, the other day when the president actually said that the procurement officers should actually be taken through a vetting process, you see a judge actually coming and saying, no, you are wrong, that cannot happen. Yeah, although I also think there's a way that letter should have been framed to avoid those kind, yes, of legal issues. Mm-hmm. Because, for example, Bwana Kenya should just have said that we want to counter-check the details they forwarded to us on a declaration of their wife.
That's down to the Attorney General, you know, and the kind of advice he gives, yeah, the government.